The Wake Up Crew, WGNS.
Good morning, Rutherford County. You're listening to The Wake Up Crew with John Dinkins, Brian Barrett, and Dalton Barrett.
It's a beautiful day in this neighborhood, a beautiful day for a neighbor. Would you be mine? Could you be mine?
And good morning, everyone. Welcome to the Thursday edition of The Wake Up Crew. This is July 25th, episode 1456. And time is moving fast. As you can tell by the calendar, the first half day for schools is only August, coming up on August 7th. That's just 13 days away.
2 weeks from yesterday.
Yeah. And tax-free weekend is this Friday through Sunday. When do we go get school supplies for my family?
Day before school starts?
Yeah. No, we get them before tax day.
Oh, yeah. You've already gotten them then.
Yeah, we've forgotten them. Why do we do that? I have no idea. And it's Throwback Thursday. What year are we throwback into this year, this time?
Well, I don't know. It's kind of up to you.
You know, somebody, I did bring up, somebody brought up I saw it the other day, and it brought in my head a throwback. You know, we're doing years right now, but do you remember Bellacino's?
The restaurant?
Well, it was a
sandwich
pizza place.
Yeah. We're supposed to be getting another one, I think.
No, they went out of business. You're not following me.
Okay.
The Tennessee Cash Card place, you know, you buy the orange Tennessee Cash where you pick up loans and cash real quick. They went in those Bellacino buildings.
Oh, okay.
But I was driving by Old Fort the other day, and I happened to see, oh, man, Bellacino's. That was a good little place to eat. Mr. Gaddy's was a good little place to eat. Somebody said they're getting one somewhere, Mr. Gaddy's. I forgot where. Not here, I don't think, but...
Well,
somewhere reasonably close. And then, I always get back memories of the place and Rack's Roast Beef, that location that had that great salad bar. You're not going to see many salad bars much anymore.
Probably not.
There'll be some. There'll be a few, but not as many as there were. They were real popular at one time till they found out when you put a 40-pound salad out, it's about as fattening as, you know, buying a hamburger.
There was, I can't remember the name of, we had one here, sandwich shop, and they went out of business. There's one, if you go down the old highway, you know, into Wilson County, if you go by Wilson Central High School and cross over the interstate, there's one right across. And
you're not talking about Snow White. There was a Snow White in Lebanon.
No, this is actually probably Mount Juliet.
Hmm.
It's right there at the...
What are you doing in Mount Juliet all the time? I meant to ask that. Why are you in Mount Juliet all the time?
Well, it's been a
minute. Explain this to me. Yeah. No, you and Dalton went just the other day. We were talking about that hot dog place.
Well, he went. Yeah, I didn't go. We did go into a ball game somewhere. I saw it. But there's a sandwich shop that was there that was here in Murfreesboro for a long time, and I think it's coming back, and I cannot remember the name
Larry's?
Of it. No, it was a chain.
Substation? Sub?
That's why I was, when you said Bellacino's.
Quiznos?
It's not Quiznos, yeah. I'll think of it.
Okay, or maybe you're seeing things. One of the two, but anyway, just had that kind of got my attention when I saw that. I just remember those Bellacino's days. And now they send loans out. You can't miss it. It's right off the...
I guess it's true.
It's that UT Orange, I think, isn't it? Something like that.
Yeah, yeah.
Well, we hope everybody's having a great day and a great morning so far. It's awful early, but Thursday, this is what we do today. We have Villages of Murfreesboro are going to be our guest. We're going to talk to them, and we're going to throw it back for Thursday. We have dad jokes. We have Today in History, celebrity birthdays. You name it, we just about got it. And to include that we have news and weather and traffic throughout the hour and CBS Sports Brief. Have I covered just about everything that we possibly could cover?
You have. There is a Bellacino's Pizza and Grinders.
Oh, okay. So you've seen it somewhere else.
It's I-40 at Highway 109.
Oh, off Gallatin Road, kind of like that.
Yeah.
The Gallatin area.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
But that must be in that little...
It's just right off of the interstate.
Yeah, it's right in that little interstate stop off right there.
Yeah.
Bellacino's. They used to have good sandwiches. You remember those?
I do.
Or do you even remember it?
I do. I stopped there.
And what was the name of the place, the pizza place that we went to that after ball games? What was the name of that? Mazio's?
Yes.
Yeah, Mazio's. I get confused with Mario's or Matteo's, which is over there by you now. But they had the pizza with the cheese. The pepperonis were inside the cheese.
I know.
That
was the best. It kept the pepperonis all in the right place.
Had a little upstairs level. Mm-hmm. It was a neat place. All right, 617 here on the Wake Up Crew. Hope you're joining us this morning. It's Thursday.
Checking your Rutherford County weather. Patchy fog possible in spots early today. Otherwise, mostly cloudy. Showers and storms in the area. Highs top out near 86 degrees. Winds north-northwesterly, around 5 miles per hour. Tonight, chance for more showers and storms. Patchy fog could redevelop in spots after midnight. Lows drop to 71. And shower and storm chances continue on Friday. I'm weatherology meteorologist Phil Jenska with your Wake Up Crew forecast. Right now, it's 72.
Habitat for Humanity's Legacy Point subdivision is making dreams come true.
It just does so much for the community when everyone can participate in home ownership. It builds stronger communities.
And you help build Habitat homes whenever you save at the Habitat Restore.
You know, that's a great investment for them, and it changes their life.
The Habitat Restore is at 850 Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. Boulevard.
Murfreesboro Funeral Home and Cremation Services.
What type of services they would think they would want?
Staff members are caring, who understand that each family is unique.
We ask them the questions.
Keith Stapleton, manager of the Murfreesboro Funeral Home, off of South Church Street.
Make one of our Rutherford County locations your pre- or post-voting spot. Stop by Toots and make sure you get out and vote.
Toots.
This is Nick Hayes with Toots Restaurants, reminding you to get out and vote and stop by one of our locations for a $6.99 lunch special afterwards.
Hi, this is Wade Hayes of Toots Restaurants. It's an election year, so it's very important that you get out and vote. Right, Jack?
Yep. It's real important that everyone gets out and vote this year.
Good food and fun.
At Heritage South Community Credit Union, we help when others won't. It's what our members tell us we do every day. The older model car you need to get to work? Yeah, we've helped with that. When you have a financial emergency and don't know where to turn, we've helped with that. Repairing your credit? Yes, we've helped with that. How about a second chance at a checking account? We've even helped with that. Experience the Heritage South difference. Learn more at heritagesouth.org. Insured by NCUA, Equal Housing Lender.
Renewable natural gas is an incredible resource with the ability to power your home and lifestyle. At Middle Point, we've broken ground on a state-of-the-art facility that will capture natural gas on-site and repurpose it into sustainable pipeline-quality gas. Once operational, this facility will produce enough energy to heat 40,000 homes per year. Learn more about this at middlepointlandfill.com. For public services, we are sustainability in action.
Hi, this is Stan with Parks Auction Company, and by now you've probably heard our commercials and know that we are committed to helping you increase your investments. Call 896-4600 to set an appointment with me or one of my team members. That's 896-4600. Parks Auction Company, we handle everything.
From the Fox Sports Studios in Los Angeles, here's Eddie Garcia.
In Major League Baseball games of note, the Astros beat the A's 8-1 while the Mariners fall to the Angels 2-1. Seattle gets swept in the three-game series. They're 1-5 since the All-Star break, and Houston now moves into first place in the AL West, one game up on Seattle. Mets take down the Yankees in the Bronx 12-3. Francisco Lindor, two homers, drove in five for the Mets as they move into the number two wildcard spot in the National League. For the Yankees, they were swept in the Subway Series 0-4 against the Mets this season. Orioles still have a game and a half lead on the Yankees for first in the AL East despite losing to the Marlins 6-3. Dodgers' five-game winning streak is snapped. The NL West leaders fall to the Giants 8-3. Twins walk off with a 5-4 win over the Phillies. Minnesota took 2 of 3 from the top team in baseball, and they're the number two wildcard team in the American League. Brewers on top in the NL Central beat the Cubs 3-2. They're 4-1 since the All-Star break. Guardians, top team in the AL Central, edged the Tigers 2-1.
The Wake Up Crew, WGNS.
With John Dinkins, Brian Barrett, and Dalton Barrett.
Oh, we're moving on. It's 6:21. Time is just flying by, you know? Just flying by.
Seems to be.
Yeah. I just keep getting older. Scary. We're powered by Middle Tennessee Electric, MTE's charitable foundation, Sharing Change. It's funded by members who round up their electric bills to the nearest dollar each month as a donation and support hundreds of nonprofits. Find out more at sharingchange.com. www.thehoosiersfootball.org. Glad you're with us here on this Thursday morning, and we want to, I guess, I had listened to an answer machine that I left a message. You know how they say, leave a message, and you can hear your message or re-record it or whatever?
Right, right.
So I listened to it, and I sound like a Boss Hog from the Dukes of Hazzard or something. It was awful. Well, my number, and I'm, what? You know. I have a real Southern accent.
Did you re-record the message?
I did.
Hi. Did it sound better the next time?
Diggins, yes, I tried to eliminate. There's two things. If I'm mad, I kind of talk more Southern. If I'm really, really relaxed, I talk more Southern.
So which were you in that instance?
Mad. When I was leaving the message.
Because you had to leave a message?
Yeah. So. Don't have any idea if it's going to get back. I don't know if they're going to return my message. I don't know.
People don't really respond.
They want you to go to. They want you to go to email. They want you to go to portals and all that. And I'm like going. I'm just ornery enough to not apply to that.
Not going
to
do it, huh?
No. Am I ill? Can you tell I'm ill this morning?
Maybe just a little bit.
Okay. I guess I missed Dalton. Not
all
really.
All right.
It's time for our song of the day for July 25th. And I think everybody from 1985 is going to remember this one.
Yeah, the second biggest hit of the year, 1985, from Madonna.
Now, I never was a big, huge fan of Madonna.
Me either.
There's a couple of songs I like. I didn't care for this one.
No. And Michael Jackson really kind of battled for, you know,
and
in the 80s
Michael,
and 90s.
I didn't love everything he did either.
No, not really.
You know? So we liked The Dinosaur and stuff like that. Debbie Gibson. That was our favorite in the 80s. Yeah, Tiffany. Yeah, you always bring her up.
Well, if you say Debbie Gibson, you got to say Tiffany.
I guess so. Wes McCurry is today's Good Neighbor of the Day for helping with a car issue and coming through with a rental. Way to go, Wes. He's going to receive flowers from Ryan Flowers Coffee and Gifts at News Radio WGNS.
So if you want to send in a Good Neighbor of the Day, go to our web portal, WGNSradio.com. Just go to the website, /Good Neighbor. You'll get to the web form there. You'll get that same web form if you text neighbor to our number, 615-893-1450. Or if you want to throw it in the mail, we'll take it that way, too. John, did you know that there are more chickens than people in the world?
I can't believe that. Really?
Mm-hmm.
More chickens than
more
people.
More chickens.
It's 624.
Stones River Manor offers a secure environment for their residents.
I don't think anybody could find any better place to go. I checked around before I moved here.
Stones River Manor is a Christian, not-for-profit senior living community.
I just really like living here. I'm happy.
And I love the friendliness and the family attitude that they have here.
Start the journey. Visit them online at stonesrivermanor.com or stop by. They're near the intersection of Haynes Drive and Memorial Boulevard.
Here's a question. What do you want from your electric co-op?
I want expert advice on going 100% solar.
I want to go green without breaking the bank.
I want to meet my sustainability goals.
I want solar to be simple.
Done, 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 done.
I want to save the planet.
Little hero, let's start with one of MTE's solar programs first. Energy Service Life. That's Middle Tennessee Electric. We're here to get done what matters most to you. Learn more at MTE.com.
Now, an update from the WGNSradio.com News Center.
I'm Ron Jordan. Tennessee tourism generated a record $30.6 billion in direct visitor spending and saw 144 million visitors to the state in 2023. Newly released data from Tourism Economics and the Tennessee Department of Tourist Development says Tennessee's direct visitor spending increased 6.2% in 2023. This follows two consecutive years of double-digit growth, driving Tennessee to a 125% recovery over 2019 pre-pandemic levels. Tourism revenue in Rutherford County has risen significantly every year for the past 3 years. When county-by-county numbers for the last year are released, the upward trend is expected to be confirmed once again. Police in Murfreesboro are investigating a possible simple assault that took place on Target Tuesday around 2:30 p.m. Police say the woman victim is okay. Officers are currently working to identify the man involved in the incident. Authorities have assured the public that there is no immediate threat. The investigation is ongoing, and police are asking anybody with any information to come forward. More details as we get them on WGNS. We are in the final stretch for early voting. The last day to vote early is this Saturday. The state and federal primary, the Rutherford County general election, and Murfreesboro City municipal races. Ballots could be cast at any polling location in the county, which means you can cast your vote at the most convenient polling station. If you're voting early at the elections office on the public square, you can vote from 7 a.m. to 7 p.m. weekdays, 8 to noon on Saturday. Poll hours at all other locations are weekdays from 10 to 6, and Saturday from 8 to noon. News on demand 24/7 at WGNSradio.com. I'm Ron Jordan reporting.
The Good Neighbor Network, on air and online at WGNSradio.com. Rutherford County's most trusted source for local news.
The Wake Up Crew, WGNS.
With John Dinkins, Brian Barrett, and Dalton Barrett.
It's 6:27. We've got a reminder that we have Good Neighbor events coming up, and also we're going to take a look at the weather. And our first look at traffic today. How's traffic been lately? Brian, in your opinion?
Bad.
Bad?
Mm-hmm. Everywhere.
5 to 6. Whew. Pretty rough.
Afternoons, awful. Thompson Lane, trying to go down from 2 lanes to 1. Terrible.
My worst is when you're trying to get it from 04 to turn left on Thompson.
I avoid that intersection at all costs.
It takes about 15 minutes to get through it.
If I can avoid Old Fort Parkway, I will.
Yeah.
I even go 840 to get on the interstate there instead of going to Old Fort or Medical Center. Medical Center's not as bad as Old Fort, but if I can avoid those, I'll do it.
You stay on Memorial? Depends on what time of the day for Memorial.
I usually don't drive home Memorial for sure.
So
I don't drive
where do you
in
get all your
mind.
Little food? Where do you buy all your little pickup food? Do you somebody brings it, delivers it to you?
For like what?
Like dinner.
At dinner.
Yeah.
Well, I may go when I get home.
Oh,
and what, you know, 6, 7 o'clock, something
you're
like
eating,
that.
You're eating too late.
Well, probably.
Need to eat earlier than that.
But Broad Street, much easier to drive home or drive in. It's the same exact mileage. But if I go Memorial, it takes me an extra 5 minutes at best every time.
Yeah.
Just so many more traffic lights, more congestion.
We've kind of got it made here with our job because we can get in before traffic's even out there.
Right.
And then we leave, even your show. Mm-hmm. Well, you stay all day pretty much, though. Well, you can leave sometimes, 3:30,
well,
whatever.
Well, depending. Yeah.
I mean, 6 to 2:30 is a long day, dude.
Yeah, can be. But if it's after 4 o'clock... Sometimes I'll even go down Broad and turn on to Northfield to then go to Sulphur Springs and come the back way.
Yeah, that's a good way to go. Yeah, that's a good way. Got to learn them. Got to learn all the little.
Yeah. I mean, there's hardly ever any congestion, and I can get home. Maybe it's a few miles longer, but I can get home quicker.
Well, I know you're going to find this hard to believe, but I've gone down South Church Street rather than get on 99 to go home.
Well, I can see
because
that.
Because at least it's flowing. You know, the lights are all,
yeah,
and there's no construction, that kind of thing. The only bad thing about South Church is unless there's a wreck.
True.
And then you're doomed.
Well, turning off of South Church onto Middle Tennessee, sometimes to get from Middle Tennessee to New Salem is awful.
Oh, yeah. It's bad.
Trying to turn left right there?
They almost have the four lane. At least on one side, they got it done. So what they'll do, you know, they'll move everything over and everybody go down that side while they fix the other side. A lot of ditches and a lot of things they got to.
Well, hopefully this probably is the longest part, doing the new.
Right.
Then just resurface the other.
Yeah.
Yeah. Maybe they're a little further along than halfway, we can hope.
Yeah, but you don't ever have to go down that way, so you don't worry about it much.
I try to avoid it at all costs, yeah.
I don't know why. That's kind of rude.
It's time for Today in History.
When you turn to Turner Security, powered by TechCore, you can leave your security issues at the door.
Turn to Turner Security.
You're a good neighbor station, WGNS.
Ask not what your country can do for you.
I'm Ryan Barrett.
Ask what you can do for your country.
I'm John Dinkins.
I have a dream.
This is Dalton Merritt.
Tear down this wall.
All right, we go back to the year 1814, and engineer George Stephenson introduced the first steam locomotive. And in 1946, at Club 500 in Atlantic City, New Jersey, Dean Martin and Jerry Lewis staged their first show as a comedy team. That kind of acted almost as an accident. He was there one night, and he came up, he played the stooge in the audience.
Oh.
And it was kind of the way they started doing it. 1964, Beatles album Hard Day's Night goes number one, stays number one for 14 weeks.
It's been a hard day's night, and I've been working like a dog. It's been a hard day's night, I should be
sleeping.
Can
you imagine being on number one for 14 weeks? I guess not.
The Wake Up Crew is.
Yeah, with number one. 1966, the Supremes released the single You Can't Hurry Love.
Can't hurry love, you just have to work. She said love don't come easy. It's a game of give and take.
And in 1975, David Bowie releases the single Fame. Took me a long time to figure out he was saying Fame.
Yeah.
You're
heard
not
this
David
song?
Bowie guy,
no,
though, either.
Really.
Yeah. In 1985, spokeswoman for Rock Hudson confirms he has AIDS. And 2016, Verizon announces a $4.83 billion purchase of Yahoo.
Yahoo!
Forgot they were Yahoo before they were Verizon. Cool.
Yeah.
That's pretty cool. Hey, Brandon Brooks is standing by with Rewind. We've got more to come here on the Wake Up Crew. It's 6:33.
This is CBS Rewind. July 25th, 1980.
Somebody step on a duck.
The release of the movie.
Cinderella Story.
Caddyshack.
Hey, you want to make $14 the hard way?
This date in 1984.
In my window,
R&B singer Big Mama Thornton.
You ain't nothing but a hound dog.
Died at 57.
You ain't nothing but a hound dog.
And July 25th, 1997.
Tonight I come to you with a pledge to change America's policy.
The release of the action movie.
Atrocity and terror are not political weapons.
Air Force One.
And to those who would use them.
Starring Harrison Ford.
Your day is over.
I'm Brandon Brooks.
Get off my plane.
And that's Rewind.
Sponsored by Progressive Insurance. Making it easy to save money. When you bundle your auto policy with home, condo, or renters, you'll earn a multi-policy discount. Easy to bundle, easy to save. Visit progressive.com.
Checking your Rutherford County weather. Patchy fog possible in spots early today. Otherwise, mostly cloudy. Showers and storms in the area. Highs top out near 86 degrees. Winds north-northwesterly, around 5 miles per hour. Tonight, chance for more showers and storms. Patchy fog could redevelop in spots after midnight. Lows drop to 71. And shower and storm chances continue on Friday. I'm weatherology meteorologist Phil Jenska with your Wake Up Crew forecast. Right now it's 72.
Good morning. Clearing up an accident right at the intersection of Lebanon Pike and Disbane Drive there in Donelson. It's building at times already out here on I-40 through the Mount Julian area headed towards Hermitage, wrapping up a wreck in Rutherford County. It's 840 going eastbound just up from Jefferson Pike. Still some flashing lights there. Hey, whether you need a new roof, roof repair, or a roof inspection, call Independent Roofing Specialist today at 991-2358. Online at irsroofs.com. I'm Commander Chuck with your on-time traffic.
This is Good Neighbor Events with Bart Walker. Brought to you by the law offices of John Day and Americare Pest Control.
I've got pesties, buzzing rodents running all through my house. Ants chewing wood, and look, there's a mouse. I've overrun with pests, pests, but you're gonna be sure. Safe and secure. It's the last rites for those pests. Call the best of the best to get rid of your pests.
893-7111. Americare Services Incorporated. Call us today. 893-7111.
WGNS encourages you to shop local.
The Woman's Club 2024 Legacy Gathering will be Saturday, August the 10th. It's not at the Woman's Club this year because they're totally renovating that 1858 home. But this year, the Woman's Club Legacy Gathering will be at Oakland's Mansion. That's 5 until 8 o'clock in the evening on Saturday, August 10th. Get with the Woman's Club. Visit their website, womensclubmurfreesboro.org. Now don't forget, this is the final week to take advantage of early voting. Would you like to learn more about Rutherford County? Well, you need to be over at the one-room Ransom Schoolhouse this coming Saturday morning from 9 until noon. Members of the Rutherford County Historical Society will be there to share local history. It's all free, including the coffee and donuts. That's this Saturday from 9 until noon. And Ransom School is at 717 North Academy Street. That's right here in the borough. Now please give the gift of life. Give blood at the Red Cross. Call them and make an appointment. That's 800-RED-CROSS. Those are WGNS Good Neighbor events.
If someone asked, what's your more? Would you be surprised? Well, at First Bank, knowing your more is where we start. Whether it's seeing your kid's college graduation, seeing the world, or seeing the ocean from your patio, your more helps us see who you are. That's why First Bank offers you more time, more access to local lenders and leaders, more answers, and more products. So tell us, what's your more? First Bank. Bank local. Get more. Member FDIC.
This is Stan Vaught. I'm a lot like you, a husband, father, farmer, auctioneer, and community supporter. I'm now a candidate for school board in the Las Casas, Walter Hill, Milton, Leanna, Oakland, and Sigel communities. I believe in community schools, vocational education, and getting education back to the basics. I'd appreciate your support for school board.
Early voting going on now through July 27th. Election day is August 1st. Paid for by Stan Vaught for school board, Stan Vaught treasurer.
Here's Dr. Craig McCabe at McCabe Vision Center.
We have treatments for the skin of your face. So not only do we want you to see young, we want you to look younger too and get rid of a lot of that sun damage.
Dr. Craig McCabe, the eye doctor you hear on the radio.
Maybe you've got dark spots, acne, rosacea, even wrinkles. We can now treat.
McCabe Vision Center on Heritage Park Drive, just off Memorial, behind SunTrust Bank.
All right, guys, load them up.
Market vendors make the trek to Murfreesboro.
We've got the sweet corn.
From over a dozen Middle Tennessee counties.
Potatoes.
To bring you a wide variety of seasonal fruits, vegetables, meats.
Got the fresh cut bacon on there.
Eggs, flowers, plants, shrubs, and trees.
I'm so glad you guys are back.
We love what we do.
The Rutherford County Farmers Market at the Indoor Open Air Community Center at the Lane Agri Park in Murfreesboro.
Open every Tuesday and Friday until the end of October, 7 to noon.
The Wake Up Crew, WGNS.
This is The Wake Up Crew with John Dinkins, Brian Barrett, and Dalton Barrett.
It's time for the dad joke of the day. Wise guy.
It's 21 minutes before 7 o'clock. What's the temperature out there, Brian? I'm just kidding. I saw that look of panic on your face.
I don't have it up here.
Yeah, that's okay. It's all right. It's okay. I'm not expecting. We got people to do that. We got people to do that. We don't have to spend our time, you know, just giving time and weather and all that. We pretty much got people to do that for us.
Why not?
Yeah. Well, nobody does the time, but
you do.
The thing, the clock at the square up on Public Square, it rings.
Top of the hour.
Top of the hour. Yeah. Dad joke of the day.
All right.
Let's see. You had a 5-4 and a 4. Well, no, 3-5.
There was a 3-point something.
3-point, yeah. Yeah,
yeah, in there.
Does it really matter?
Not really.
Okay, as long as Alan thinks you're great.
Your jokes are amazing. Yeah.
What does it matter what I think?
You know, I was driving down the road, and there was a lobster stand. It said lobster tails for just $2.
Oh, no.
So I gave him $2, and he said, once upon a time, there was a lobster.
You know, I'm more mad at myself for falling into that. That wasn't the punchline I was expecting.
No, no.
But it was pretty good. I'm going to go give it a 4. A little long, but still good.
CBS News
brief. The remains of five Israeli hostages have been recovered from a tunnel in Khan Yunis. Reporter Linda Gradstein from Jerusalem.
They were killed on October 7th when thousands of Hamas gunmen surged into Israel and their bodies taken to Gaza.
President Biden will meet with Israeli Prime Minister Netanyahu at the White House after addressing the nation last night on his decision to drop out of the presidential race.
The great thing about America is here, kings and dictators do not rule. The people do. History is in your hands.
Last Friday's massive IT outage has cost the global economy a staggering amount. CBS's Cammie McCormick has the numbers.
The outage disrupted everything from aviation to banking, and one cyber analytics firm estimates global insured losses are likely to range from $400 million to $1.5 billion.
CBS News Brief. I'm Deborah Rodriguez.
Now, an update from the WGNSRadio.com News Center.
I'm Ron Jordan. A former special education teacher sounded the alarm after the Rutherford County School District decided not to renew his contract. The teacher, Perry Loudon, feels it's been constant roadblocks ever since he spoke up for his special ed students who had been left out of Oakland High School's homecoming parade last October. While the school cited concerns for the students' health and safety, Loudon believes the school violated federal law. Ever since speaking up for his students, Loudon says it's been an uphill battle to get the principal to agree to activities he wanted to do. Loudon says the final straw came when carelessness by another teacher led to a student being left in the classroom. He says he got the blame and was suspended. Officials looking into that fatal shooting of a man at a home in the Beech Grove area of Coffee County Wednesday. Law enforcement responded to a shooting after a man was found dead at a home on Shiloh Road. District Attorney General Craig Northcott said the man died from an apparent gunshot wound. TBI is assisting the Coffee County Sheriff's Office in the investigation. Remember the problems that CrowdStrike ran into? That's the cybersecurity firm that crashed millions of computers worldwide last week. Well, it's offering its partners a $10 Uber Eats gift card as an apology. Daniel Bernard, the company's chief business officer, said to remember the firm was sending heartfelt thanks and apologies for the inconvenience. The company only sent that gift card to teammates and partners, not customers. And then CrowdStrike got bit by bad luck again. CrowdStrike said in a statement that Uber flagged it as fraud because of high usage rates. Follow us on X at WGNS Radio. I'm Ron Jordan reporting.
The Good Neighbor Network, on air and online at WGNSRadio.com. Rutherford County's most trusted source for local news.
Timmy, everybody. Great job. Next up for our fifth grade class recital, we have Samantha.
10 times better performance can make a big difference. Castrol Edge Motor Oil gives your engine 10 times better high-stress performance. Castrol Edge, better oil for maximum performance. Now through December 28th, Castrol Edge and Edge High Mileage Motor Oil are on rollback at Walmart.
Claim based on sequence dyne test under high-low conditions versus API-SP test limits.
Lanny went to college and racked up huge debt.
A little bit over $100,000.
For a degree he couldn't use? Now what?
I had a friend that went to my computer career and they talked to me about it.
He was done in just months.
I did do it online.
They even helped him get hired immediately after graduation.
One of the things I love about IT is that you can work from anywhere you want.
You could become an IT pro in just months with zero experience at My Computer Career.
It worked for me and I know it can work for you.
It's not rocket science. It's mycomputercareer.edu.
Learn to make money five ways with rental real estate. Double your money with apartments and get your map to financial freedom. And that map starts with a free workshop. Sign up now at lifestylesunlimited.com. Click on the Join Free Workshop tab and attend online or in person. That's lifestylesunlimited.com. Lifestylesunlimited.com. Again, that's lifestylesunlimited.com. Limited seating, unlimited potential.
It's summertime and it's time to do more outdoors. But do you feel out of energy, lacking motivation and mental focus? It could be low testosterone. Low T affects millions of men and it happens naturally. The solution, testosterone replacement therapy at Low T Center. I literally walk in, they check the level, and then I find out where I stand today. Right now at Low T Center, they are offering a free initial test. If you're over 30, schedule that visit at lowtcenter.com today.
Offer till July 31st. Terms and conditions apply.
Franklin's Print Works has been in Murfreesboro for over 25 years. We are a full-service commercial printer, everything from business cards, brochures, booklets, to banners. My name is Jeff Carlton. I handle sales and marketing for Franklin's Print Works. We hear a lot people who have been working with printers on the internet, had issues, and they know that if we're working with someone local, that A, they know where to find us, and B, they know that we'll take care of it because we have to take care of our neighbors. Our website is franklinsprinting.org.
Man on the Street Newsmakers, brought to you by Old National Bank in Murfreesboro.
We're excited to announce that Capstar Bank is now officially a division of Old National Bank. The friends you've made while banking right here over the years are still here, and so are those delicious, warm, homemade cookies. Everything you enjoyed about Capstar is still at Old National Bank.
In Murfreesboro at 2230 Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. Boulevard.
Come on over and enjoy warm cookies with friends while doing your banking at Old National Bank.
Old National Bank, member FDIC, equal housing lender.
Information you need.
We don't have enough emergency shelter space, but the real issue is affordable housing.
That's Amber Hampton.
We have folks that come through the shelter, they get a check every single month, and they just can't find housing. The list is just insanely long. We live in a college town, so college kids are going to scoop up the cheaper housing faster. There's a lot of folks that if we could find them available places to rent for like $400 or $500 a month, we could put them in housing today, but it just doesn't exist right now.
Murfreesboro Rescue's Ed Grimes says people need to work together.
Today, there is a collaborative effort trying to bring organizations together so that we don't duplicate services. Right now, it's still an underserved population because we don't have that bed space that we need. The services that are being provided today are definitely services that are needed.
Hampton concluded.
We've got the pieces of the puzzle that we need. We just don't have enough. So, like, there's not enough outreach happening. There's not enough shelter happening. But we have the pieces. There's just not enough of it happening to where it's hitting what we need. We all work really well together, and we've got the pieces of the puzzle that we need. We just don't have enough.
And that's information you need from WGNS, focusing on our local homeless problems.
The Wake Up Crew, WGNS.
With John Dinkins, Brian Barrett, and Dalton Barrett.
It's 12 minutes before the hour of 7 o'clock, and again, I'm saying how time flies. It's just going by so fast. This whole hour is flying by.
Just moving on.
Hey, didn't we discuss, it was National Ice Cream Day the other day, wasn't it?
I believe so.
Yeah.
I know we talked about Bluebell vanilla.
Yeah, I made that comment. I got a pretty negative look from Dalton.
Well, I'm the one who said I didn't care for the vanilla.
Oh, yeah, of course. Too strong, maybe? The vanilla too strong for you, buddy? You like that bean, vanilla bean, don't you?
Kinda.
Yeah.
But I'm not really big on vanilla. My favorite, I guess, actually, is probably strawberry out of the three most popular.
Oh, really? Gosh, what's wrong with
you? Gotta be in the mood for chocolate.
What's wrong with you?
Why?
Who in their right mind is there for, oh, my favorite strawberry ice cream? No.
Well, out of the three biggies, I don't try the Neapolitan very often. So for the birthday cake that we did for Dalton a while,
it was strawberry.
No.
Oh.
It was the Great Divide from Bluebell, which had vanilla and chocolate.
Yeah.
So you could have your choice.
Oh, such good. That's such good ice cream.
Yeah.
They taste like, to me, like when you crank it yourself.
Really?
It's really strong vanilla. I like that strong vanilla flavor. But obviously you don't. But I want some strawberry.
Well, I'm saying out of the top three.
Wow. So Neapolitan, if I gave you a box of Neapolitan, you'd be just dishing out that there wouldn't be any strawberry left in it.
I would eat the strawberry for sure, yeah.
What's your favorite? Do they make a strawberry ice cream that I might be interested in?
Yeah, Bluebell makes one, I think.
Oh, do they?
Yeah. Wow. They've got all kinds of flavors.
They make a good chocolate fudge ice cream, chocolate. But then again, that's chocolate.
Well, I'm not huge on chocolate for some reason, especially ice cream.
I like the strawberry ice cream that has the actual strawberries in the ice cream,
oh,
too.
Oh,
yeah.
I guess out of all of them, probably peach.
Mm.
With the good chunks of peach in it.
So do you, what company makes that? Is that like Breyers? Doesn't Breyers make peach?
I'm pretty sure I've had a Bluebell peach before.
Mm.
I know they have.
Have you had their banana pudding?
I have. Well. It was okay.
Yeah. All right.
There's a blackberry cobbler I think they've got, which mm-hmm. was good.
Did you like it?
Mm-hmm.
So you do eat Bluebell ice cream?
Yeah, it's nothing against Bluebell. I'm just not necessarily a huge vanilla
fan.
If
you don't like cookies and cream, then I take it, because it's got both combinations
not
that
much.
You wouldn't like. So if you go to, say, Baskin-Robbins, what flavor are you going to get?
Probably a fruity flavor. Peach or strawberry or something like that. I'm not getting a chocolate mint or anything like that.
No, you're a real man. You get a fruity flavor. Like what? Peach? Strawberry?
Yeah.
Okay.
Or a sherbet.
Nothing against it. Oh, I do like sherbet now. Mm-hmm. But I don't like it in cones.
Oh, no. No, it's not very good in cones at all.
When I had COVID, you know, the sherbet revived me. I ate it at the hospital. And then I went home, and that's all the only thing that I liked was sherbet.
So that's why we couldn't find any for a while.
Uh-huh. I mean, I had to go. Brett went out, had to go across town to get a car.
Oh, really?
I was eating it for supper every night and lunch and breakfast. Wow. I mean, I didn't eat anything but that. It's weird how that one flavor. I didn't eat a solid food until, guess what? Demas's. Somebody brought me some Demas salad. And that was the first time I tasted the ranch dressing. I went, wow.
You can taste it.
I can taste it. Yes. Awesome. Birthdays?
Sure.
Anybody in the audience who's got a birthday today, happy birthday to you.
I'm disappointed.
Why is that?
Because we don't really have a lot today.
Well, that's true.
I could go to the new birthday list that I have just for emergencies like this. But I don't know if I could look it up in time, but it would probably help our situation here.
Well, there are a couple of really good ones on here.
Okay,
anyway.
All right. Okay. 1914, Woody Strode, American football end and actor. He was a member of the L.A. Rams. 1920, Rosalind Franklin, English chemist and co-discoverer of the structure of DNA.
Wow, that's impressive.
You can only hear it on our birthday list. And 1923, Estelle Getty, American actress. She played which one? The old lady? The oldest one?
Mm-hmm.
What was her name?
I want to say Maud, but I know that's not even close.
I'll give you a second to check that out. The Golden Girls. Born in, died in 2008. Traveled down the road and back again. Your heart is true. I think where you got Maud is, didn't she call her Ma?
She did call her Ma.
Yeah.
Dorothy called her Ma.
Yeah,
Sophia.
Sophia, yeah.
Petrello.
That's where you got the Ma.
Well, plus the lady who played Dorothy played in the show Maud that came before that.
Yeah. And 1954, Walter Payton, American Pro Football Hall of Fame running back. He died in 1999. A great, great running back. And 1967, Matt LeBlanc, American actor. He played Joey Tribbiani on Friends. No one told you life was gonna be this way. And that's a look at celebrity birthdays. Here's some local birthdays for you, folks. And we've got some big names. Big names. They're big, Andy. Tom Crager, Clark Blair, Kevin Furr, Peyton Hodge, Bill Nash, and Debbie Kalish all have birthdays today.
Really? Clark Blair again.
He has one every month. It
seems like.
Yeah.
Birthdays and anniversaries, call or text him in at 615-893-1450 for the Slick Pig Barbecue Birthday Club. Well, it's National Chili Hot Dog Day.
Can't beat that, brother. That's right, 655.
Checking your Rutherford County weather. Patchy fog possible in spots early today. Otherwise, mostly cloudy, showers and storms in the area. Highs top out near 86 degrees. Winds north-northwesterly, around 5 miles per hour. Tonight, chance for more showers and storms. Patchy fog could redevelop in spots after midnight. Lows drop to 71. Then shower and storm chances continue on Friday. I'm weatherology meteorologist Phil Jenska with your Wake Up Crew forecast. Right now it's 72.
LaGreen's Masonry is a local family business. They build quality brick mailboxes. LaGreen's Masonry has over 19 years experience, and they're A-plus rated by the BBB. Check their website, lagreensmasonry.com.
Good morning. Putting the final touches on this crash at the intersection of Lebanon Pike and Disbain there in Donelson. Still on the scene of that earlier wreck this morning in Rutherford County on 840 eastbound, just up from Jefferson 11 Pike. I can still see THP over there working that crash. Traffic's picking up where you would expect down I-40 eastbound coming in from Dixon County through Kingston Springs. Nash Painting is your non-franchise painting company. Mention this ad, you get a 10% discount. Call Nash Painting today at 912-2288. I'm Commander Chuck with your on-time traffic.
Hi, this is Ryan with Tire World Laverne, here to serve all your automotive needs in Rutherford County. We welcome all your fleet and commercial accounts, along with all your regular routine maintenance. Tire World, a hometown family business you can trust.
Folks, I hope you're listening every Sunday night at 8 o'clock to the Edwin Lee Raymer Show. We'll talk about some local politics, national politics, all types of topics, all types of guests. That's 8 o'clock Sunday night, Edwin Lee Raymer Show. Talk to you then.
This is Stan Vaught. I'm a lot like you, a husband, father, farmer, auctioneer, and community supporter. I'm now a candidate for school board in the Las Casas, Walter Hill, Milton, Leanna, Oakland, and Siegel communities. I believe in community schools, vocational education, and getting education back to the basics. I'd appreciate your support for school board.
Early voting going on now through July 27th. Election day is August 1st. Paid for by Stan Vaught for school board, Stan Vaught treasurer.
Novatech, Middle Tennessee's local office technology and document solutions expert, reflects the additional managed IT and print services now available to area businesses. Visit novatech.net. Novatech provides businesses with a predictable experience at a predictable expense. Novatech offers free cost analysis so you may easily choose the exact solutions to meet your needs within your budget. Visit novatech.net. That's novatech.net.
Broadcasting from the Middle Tennessee Electric Studios, MTE Sharing Change has now donated more than $11 million to local nonprofits assisting worthy causes in our community. MTE, serving to make life better since 1936.
Are you shopping for lights?
We got it!
Doors?
We got it!
Flooring?
We got it!
Furniture?
We got it, here at the Habitat Restore. 850 Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. Boulevard in Murfreesboro.
Remember, we got it today, but it may be gone tomorrow.
Find it at the Restore, yeah. We got it at the Habitat Restore.
The Habitat Restore at 850 Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. Boulevard in Murfreesboro.
The Wake Up Crew, WGNS.
With John Dinkins, Brian Barrett, and Dalton Barrett.
It's 6:58, and we want to say congratulations to Wes McCurry, today's Good Neighbor of the Day, for helping with a car issue and coming through with a rental. Wes McCurry is going to receive flowers from Jenny Harrison and the family over at Ryan Flowers Coffee and Gifts and News Radio WGNS.
So that is today's Good Neighbor of the Day. And if you would like to nominate someone as Good Neighbor of the Day, if you text the word neighbor to our phone number here, 615-893-1450, you'll get a reply and just tap on that link and fill out the info there. It's going to take you just a couple of minutes. You can get to that from our website as well. You can throw it in the mail, however you can get it to us. Even call later on in the day, this afternoon, talk to Melissa. She'll take that. And you've got another half an hour or so to get in your birthday and anniversary announcements. The number there, 615-893-1450. We're checking CBS World News next on WGNS, brought to you by the Low T Center and the Law Offices of John Day.
This is John Day of the Law Offices of John Day. We want to make a difference in the community we hold so dear. If you're ever injured, know that we are here for you too. Call the Law Offices of John Day.
This is John. Brian will be back with me. And in fact, he's going to lead the show coming up right after the news.
Portions of our programming have been pre-recorded. The Good Neighbor Network, WGNS, Murfreesboro, Smyrna, flagship station for MTSU sports. Courthouse clock time, 7 o'clock.
Passing the torch.
Nothing can come in the way of saving our democracy. That includes personal ambition.
On the attack.
Lion Kamala Harris, Lion, L-Y-I-N apostrophe.
Prison release blocked.
When innocence doesn't matter, what are we doing? Why even have laws?
Good morning. I'm Steve Kathan. With the CBS World News Roundup, President Biden defended his record last night and said about his decision to bow out of the 2024 race that it's now time for younger voices. CBS's Ed O'Keefe has details from the White House.
I revere this office.
but I love my country more.
Speaking from the Oval Office, President Biden explained his decision to end his campaign and support Vice President Harris instead.
You know, there is a time and a place for long years of experience in public life. There's also a time and a place for new voices. And that time and place is now.
The president praised Harris as she watched from the campaign trail in Houston.
She's experienced. She's tough. She's capable.
While he never explicitly mentioned former President Donald Trump, Biden did say this.
We have to decide, do we still believe in honesty, decency, respect?
Now, he said he plans to focus on what he can accomplish in his last 6 months in office.
They'll continue to lower costs for hardworking families, grow our economy. I'll keep defending our personal freedoms and our civil rights. From the right to vote to the right to choose.
He also cited hopes to focus on gun control, address climate change, fight cancer, and said he'll soon share ideas on how to overhaul the Supreme Court.
Just before the president spoke, former President Trump held a campaign rally in North Carolina. CBS's Nicole Killian reports he went after the woman he'll likely face in November.
We officially defeated the worst president in the history of our country, Crooked Joe Biden.
In his first solo rally since President Biden's exit, former President Trump quickly pivoted to his new likely rival,
Lion Kamala Harris,
frequently mispronouncing her name and taking aim at her record from the economy to the border.
Lion Kamala Harris has been the ultra-liberal driving force behind every single Biden catastrophe.
Israeli Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu meets today with President Biden and also with Vice President Harris. After a tumultuous day in D.C. that saw protests from families of hostages held by Hamas and Netanyahu's forceful speech to Congress.
When we stand together, something very simple happens. We win, they lose.
Israel today recovered the bodies of five Israelis in Gaza who had been killed back in October. Wildfires threaten the landscape from California to Canada. CBS's Jonathan Vigliotti says one fire in central California more than tripled in size overnight.
A new wildfire is raging out of control, breaking out just north of Sacramento, sending flames up into trees and devouring thousands of acres. Fire crews drove between walls of flames near the town of Chico, where hundreds of residents are under evacuation orders. Other harrowing scenes are coming out across the Pacific Northwest, including eastern Oregon, where nearly three dozen large wildfires are running rampant.
Delta Airlines says passengers should expect normal operations today after a week of cancellations and chaos. CBS's Chris Van Cleve says also in the mix is Delta CEO Ed Bastian's trip to the Olympics.
That trip is being sharply criticized by the nation's largest flight attendant union, telling us while Ed was flying to Paris, crews were sleeping in airports across the country. Delta was already reimbursing people for hotels, meals, and transportation to and from the airport if they'd been disrupted. But the airline now says it will also reimburse people who bought tickets on other airlines, rented cars, or took a train to get home.
Big change for Southwest Airlines. For the first time in more than 50 years, it will start assigning seats, as most other airlines already do. 4 minutes after the hour.
Think O'Reilly Auto Parts for all your car care needs. Get the parts and service you need fast from the professional parts people at O'Reilly Auto Parts.
When was the last time you said, I love? No, really. When was the last time you said, I love my pillow? We think we know why this is so difficult. Because your pillow sucks. That's right. As soon as you lay on it, it needs to be scrunched and adjusted, which some pitch man convinced you is a good thing. And in the middle of the night, it starts all over again. I Love My Pillow is not a cheap infomercial pillow. In fact, for the last 10 years, I Love My Pillow has only been available in the finest bedding shops. The secret to I Love My Pillow is in our proprietary homemade foam. I guarantee you'll be saying, I love my pillow. Go to ilovemypillow.com to get sized for your custom-made pillow, handcrafted in the heart of America. I guarantee this pillow won't suck. Or your money back.
Order now and get a free travel pillow. Just put promo code LOVE. That's promo code LOVE at ilovemypillow.com.
A school officer charged in connection with the Uvalde massacre will be in court today.
Adrian Gonzalez, charged in June with 29 counts of child endangerment, is expected to plead not guilty at the Uvalde County Courthouse. According to the indictment, Gonzalez failed to engage the gunman after hearing gunshots and failed to follow his active shooter training.
Adrian Gonzalez literally passed by the shooter and did nothing to stop him. He should have just pled guilty and did his time.
Brett Cross's son, Uzziah Garcia, one of the 19 kids killed. Last week, former Uvalde School District Police Chief Pete Arredondo pleaded not guilty to 10 counts of child endangerment. Chris Fox, 4 CBS News, Austin.
Missouri's Supreme Court has halted the immediate release of a man whose murder conviction was overturned earlier this week. The state's attorney general has been working to block the release of Christopher Dunn. His wife was headed to the prison to get him when she got the news.
What is the purpose of keeping an innocent person in prison? A person who two prosecutors have said is innocent.
Dunn has been in prison for 3 decades. The judge who ordered him freed said there was evidence of his innocence. The FDA has expanded its vegetable recall in the recent listeria outbreak. First, it was cucumbers, now nearly 20 veggies sold at Aldi, Walmart, Kroger, and other local stores in 18 states have been included. The 70-year-old hiker who went missing in Northern California last Friday has been found alive. Police Sergeant Kevin Griffith.
The fisherman who was out on the lake thought he heard an owl, and as he pushed farther onto the lake, he actually realized it was a human voice.
He says the man survived on a handful of berries and river water. Quite a dive yesterday for financial exchanges. Indexes had their worst day since 2022, with steep losses on the NASDAQ and the S&P 500. The Dow was down 504 points. Profit reports from Tesla and Alphabet helped trigger it. Market strategist Art Hogan says it's been a rocky early summer.
We haven't seen a 5% pullback since April of this year. So the market was due for that. This is normal volatility, and the seasonality of the back half of July through October tends to be more volatile and more negative.
A Tennessee man found out he was the winner of a $1 million lottery prize when police contacted him. Turns out a clerk at the gas station in Murfreesboro, where he bought the scratch-off ticket, is accused of stealing it after saying it was worthless. Detective Steve Craig says store video is being used as evidence.
He threw it on top of the trash. He took the trash outside. And if you follow him on the camera, you can see him grab the ticket, put it in his pocket. It's pretty obvious. Good enough for me to put in front of 12 jurors and make sure that they all come to the same conclusion.
Time on the roundup, 8 past the hour.
Sorry, but we actually have a wait list for our Monstera.
Shaw's greenhouse is really bringing in the green.
We can't keep snake plants and stuff.
She needs a construction manager to build on her roots and grow.
We could add a whole section for ferns. Here we'd have dahlias, dahlias, and more dahlias.
Indeed can help her hire great people fast.
I need Indeed.
Indeed you do. You can schedule and conduct virtual interviews all from your employer dashboard. Visit Indeed.com/credit and get $75 towards your first sponsored job. Terms and conditions apply.
eBay Motors is here for the ride. Go ahead, feel your engine. Admire that perfectly installed exhaust. Your vehicle's moving along this freeway like it was made from fresh installs and a whole lot of love. With eBay Motors, you get over 122 million parts to keep it running. And with eBay Guaranteed Fit, they'll be the perfect fit every time. Plus, at these prices, well, we're burning rubber, not cash. Keep your ride or die alive at ebaymotors.com. Eligible items only. Exclusive.
That's the latest national and world news from CBS News Radio. I'm Steve Kathan. Time to get back to Brian, John, and Dalton for more of the Wake Up Crew here on News Radio WGNS.
The information continues this morning here from WGNS. I'm Brian Barrett, John Dinkins, Dalton Barrett along here in just a moment. But let's first get a check on traffic and weather together. It's brought to you by locally owned and operated Toots.
Make one of our Rutherford County locations your pre- or post-voting spot. Stop by Toots and make sure you get out and vote.
Toots.
This is Nick Hayes with Toots Restaurants, reminding you to get out and vote and stop by one of our locations for a $6.99 lunch special afterwards.
Hi, this is Wade Hayes of Toots Restaurants. It's an election year, so it's very important that you get out and vote. Right, Jack?
Yep. It's real important that everyone gets out and vote this year.
Good food and fun.
Checking your Rutherford County weather. Patchy fog possible in spots early today. Otherwise, mostly cloudy. Showers and storms in the area. Highs top out near 86 degrees. Winds north-northwesterly, around 5 miles per hour. Tonight, chance for more showers and storms. Patchy fog could redevelop in spots after midnight. Lows drop to 71. And shower and storm chances continue on Friday. I'm weatherology meteorologist Phil Jensko with your Wake Up Crew forecast. Right now it's 73.
We're excited to announce that Capstar Bank is now officially a division of Old National Bank. Old National Bank in Murfreesboro at 2230 Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. Boulevard. Old National Bank, ready to serve you.
Old National Bank, member FDIC, equal housing lender.
Good morning. Cleanup continues on this truck crash that happened earlier this morning out in Rutherford County on 840 eastbound near Jefferson Pike. It's been limping along out through there, that section in Rutherford County, as it builds now, leaving Murfreesboro headed towards Nashville on 24 westbound. Out up through the Antioch area. It's also increasing down I-40 here coming in from Wilson County through Hermitage. Prince's Hot Chicken has new items on the menu. You got to check them out today at princeshotchicken.com. I'm Commander Chuck with your on-site traffic.
Everywhere you go in this area, you see beautiful brick mailboxes from LaGreen's Masonry. Visit their website and see their variety. LaGreen'sMasonry.com, a family business you can trust. LaGreen's Masonry.
The Wake Up Crew, WGNS.
News, traffic, weather, and fun every morning. It's the Wake Up Crew on News Radio, WGNS, with John Dinkins.
Good night, John Boy.
Brian Barrett and Dalton Barrett.
Well, good morning. Welcome into, into the Wake Up Crew. You're just cracking me up. For some reason.
I don't know why.
I don't either. It's Brian and John here on the 7 o'clock hour on this Thursday morning. Hope you're having a good one. It is the 25th of July. I wanted to say June, but that's been a month ago. Episode 1456 of the Wake Up Crew.
Hey, hi, howdy.
Howdy.
I got my new phrase.
Oh, is that it?
Hey, hi, howdy.
Tax-free
I heard
weekend.
It from somebody. Mm-hmm.
I don't think he said howdy though, did he?
Well, I didn't want to, you know,
steal it outright.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Tax-free weekend this weekend starts tomorrow, goes through Sunday, and
don't go to Walmart. Gosh, what a crowd!
It's going to be crazy, I'm afraid. But anyway, are you?
I'll go to any of the stores. Actually,
are you planning on?
No, I've already gone. Remember?
Yeah.
Yeah. I just can't.
Well, shucks.
Does taxes really save you that much?
About 10%.
10%. Okay.
So if it costs a dollar, it costs you 90 cents. Costs $100, costs you 90. Well, the more you spend.
Yeah.
Can save you really big on electronics like computers and notepads and stuff.
Yeah. What's a going rate of a computer right now?
Ooh, I would say you're going to spend at least $600 or $700.
Yeah, a computer, right.
Yeah, like a laptop kind of thing.
Yeah.
Something like that. So,
so that saves you $60.
Yeah,
$540. Right. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. So, hope you take part in that if you want. I will not be taking part in tax-free weekend.
Hmm.
Clothes too. I mean, you like to shop for clothes,
but you like computers. I would think you'd want to buy you a computer.
I've got one.
Oh,
I actually have two.
Hmm. Oh yeah, they're all like big, big, huge monitor things up in.
Yeah.
People would ever see your house, they wouldn't believe it.
I only have three monitors.
You never did go
house.
To the, I'm going to actually have an office, though. You haven't gone to that yet, have you?
Not yet. Maybe. The last time I was at Walmart was, I guess maybe Thursday, last Thursday, maybe a week ago.
Oh, wow.
And walking out as I was walking in was our pal Bob Bug, and I've meant to mention this to you. This morning he asked how you were doing.
Oh yeah,
said he listens to the morning show, and
he's doing an auction for a friend of mine not too long.
Yeah, he said it's been pretty busy.
Yeah,
he asked if you needed a calendar.
Did you say yes?
I told him, I said, you know, it's July, it can never be too early.
Yeah, I was first actually this year. He sent it to me first.
Well, I think it was the mail who got that messed up, but that's just me.
No, I don't think so.
Well,
because I kept asking you week after week after week, and finally after about 5 weeks, you got yours.
5 weeks?
Bob likes me better than he does you.
Oh, is that what it was?
Yeah. You just live on the other, on his side of town, and I don't.
Yeah. But he said, say hello.
Well, thanks, Bob. It's always good. Stan, I guess, is pretty busy.
Yeah. You know, Bob's first words were, y'all are about getting ready. You're getting ready to get pretty busy, aren't you? That's what you wanted to hear this morning.
Uh-huh. Yeah. I think that's what's wrong with me.
Oh, is it?
Yeah. I've got to look through the schedule, though, and put down the ones, highlight the ones I'm going to be at.
Has your depression set in or something? Is that what it is?
No, I mean, you know, I mean, I'm just going to highlight the games I'm going to be able to be a part of.
Well, there are 12 regular season games.
Not for you.
What do you mean for me?
I'm just trying to make it an easy blow for you, buddy.
Got to start working on that.
Yeah, I'm waiting for you to work on it before I start highlighting.
Well, I've given you a preliminary calendar.
But there's some extenuating circumstances that I have to check out.
Like
who's going to drive and that kind of thing, all that kind of stuff.
Yeah.
Got to talk about each one.
Most of them are in county, but Oakland finally found a 10th game. They're going to go to Anna, Texas, week 2.
Ooh, are we going to that?
No. Anna, Texas is, I don't know, 30, 40 miles, just guessing, outside of Dallas-Fort Worth.
Ooh.
That's quite the trip.
Yeah, he does it right, though. They have a good time.
I guess.
Spares no expense.
Well, there's a lot of expense to all of that, that's for sure. Song of the day. We are looking back at the year 1985, and in 1985, this was the second biggest hit that year. So that's Madonna's Like a Virgin. That was the second biggest hit of 1985. Tomorrow will be the biggest hit of the year, 1985, on a Friday morning.
Let me ask you a question. Would you go to a Madonna concert?
No.
Okay.
I would not.
Would you go to a Justin Timberlake concert?
Probably not. I'm not really a big concert goer.
Well, I mean, if you could go to one, Alabama was here not too long ago.
Oh, is that right?
Yeah. You liked Alabama, didn't you?
I do, yeah.
Yeah. I haven't been in for years. I don't like crowds.
That's me.
Well, we spend so much time in crowds.
I know.
Yeah.
John, there has been a recent rat brain study.
Okay. Maybe kind of came out of the clear blue.
Maybe offering some insight how our brains tell time. The lead researcher believes the findings have practical applications for how we can cope with unpleasant things in life or make the most of a good time. By monitoring the brainwave activity of rats as they repeated behaviors over the course of an hour, researchers found that we seem to feel time based on experiences. So basically, when we're bored, time feels like it's moving in reverse or slow. But when you're having fun, it goes by faster.
Yeah.
That's why you say on this show, you know, boy, time's flying this morning on the Wake Up Crew.
Well, during my hour.
What do you mean? That's very informative. When you're having fun, your brain feels it.
That first hour is fun.
Okay, thanks. We're going to take a break here for the sports news and come back with our friends from the Villages of Murfreesboro.
This is News Radio WGNS, primetime sports,
sponsored by the law offices of John Day.
From the Fox Sports studios in Los Angeles, here's Eddie Garcia.
In Major League Baseball games of note, the Astros beat the A's 8-1 while the Mariners fall to the Angels 2-1. Seattle gets swept in the three-game series. They're 1-5 since the All-Star break, and Houston now moves into first place in the AL West, one game up on Seattle. Mets take down the Yankees in the Bronx 12-3. Francisco Lindor, two homers, drove in five for the Mets as they move into the number two wildcard spot in the National League. For the Yankees, they were swept in the Subway Series 0-4 against the Mets this season. Orioles still have a game and half lead on the Yankees for first in the AL East, despite losing to the Marlins 6-3. Dodgers' five-game winning streak is snapped. The NL West leaders fall to the Giants 8-3. Twins walk off with a 5-4 win over the Phillies. Minnesota took 2 of 3 from the top team in baseball, and they're the number two wildcard team in the American League. Brewers on top in the NL Central beat the Cubs 3-2. They're 4-1 since the All-Star break. Guardians, top team in the AL Central, edged the Tigers 2-1.
This is a paid legal ad.
Hi, this is John Day of the Law Offices of John Day. For more than 30 years, my team and I have worked hard to help injured people throughout Middle Tennessee. Over that time, we've helped thousands of people get the legal help they need when they've needed it the most. And if we're not able to help or aren't the right lawyer for you, we'll do the best to point you in the right direction. If you've been injured, call the law offices of John Day for a free consultation. And remember, there's no fee unless we win your case.
When it comes to your home, memories and sentimental value are priceless. Farrah Construction can remodel your home or can update your kitchen, bath, or other rooms. I'm Ron Hall. If you can dream it, Farrah Construction can turn it into reality. Call Farrah Construction at 615-893-6120. That's Farrah Construction. I'm Ron Hall. Shop local. Let our family business help you. Farrah Construction Company.
French's Shoes and Boots is your hometown store for the latest in Southern style at unbeatable prices. Boots, boots, boots. Find the biggest selection of Southern styles from brands like Ariat, Thorogood, Twisted X, Durango, Wrangler, and more. We've got tons of choices in the latest Western wear, shoes, and accessories. Boots, boots, boots. Shoes and more. Of course, French's Shoes and Boots has you covered.
Shop at French's. French's Shoes and Boots.
1837 South Church Street in Murfreesboro.
Ascension St. Thomas Heart is the leader in Middle Tennessee for heart care, providing the most advanced options, including heart surgery and transplants. Our nationally recognized cardiac team cares for more adult hearts than anyone in the state, from AFib to heart failure, using minimally invasive options when possible to help shorten recovery, making Ascension St. Thomas Heart your first choice for routine heart care and cardiac emergencies. Schedule a heart screening or find a cardiologist at ascension.org/St. Thomas Heart.
The Wake Up Crew, WGNS.
With Brian Barrett, John Dinkins, and Dalton Barrett.
722 here on The Wake Up Crew. We are on a Thursday morning, which means we head out to the Villages of Murfreesboro. Activities Director Jeb Bowers joins us here this morning. Being the Activities Director, you've been keeping folks busy this summer, haven't you?
So since the last time we talked, we've done a whole lot of stuff. We ended June with a big trip to Bell Buckle. They have the wonderful Bell Buckle Cafe out there. And not only do they get to eat really well, but they also get to peruse the shopping out there. So they love that trip. We make that trip every few months. And it's always different depending on what season it is. But they love that trip. Moving into July, we had a big 4th of July celebration that we capped off. Being able to watch the fireworks here in Murfreesboro, we have a wonderful view. Some people don't even have to do anything but look out their window, but others, you know, we kind of gathered them outside in our parking lot area, and they got to sit there and watch the fireworks. We had a better view this year, actually, than even last year. I guess they moved it a little bit, and so they kind of got to sit there and watch it and enjoy that and not really have to worry about going anywhere to do it.
Yeah, they did kind of move the location of where they shot the fireworks this year. And I've heard more people say they had a better vantage point from it. So that's cool.
It was great. And they really, really enjoyed it. We followed that up with a state fair day. So we focused mostly on our lunchtime, and we had food that you would find at state fairs. We had hot pretzels, funnel cakes, but I think really the main attraction was those big turkey legs that you often see people walking around with.
Yeah,
that look like a kind of look like a club. So we had those, and it was we had a great time. And they, again, the food, you really never know what you're gonna get when we have these special days. And our chef Barbara, she really goes out of her way to make all of our special events that much more special with her wonderful food.
Yeah, that's cool. State Fair Day, that's a really great idea, and probably brings back a lot of memories for some of those folks.
Definitely, you know, a lot of these people, they haven't, you know, they grew up going to fairs and stuff, and it's probably been a long time since they've been to one. So we kind of tried to bring that to them. We followed that up with a trip to Lucky Lad Farms out in Eagleville, where we got to do the petting zoo, the butterfly area where you can go in this area, and butterflies are everywhere, all these different species. And then we got to enjoy the sunflowers, because right now they have sunflowers over there, and the residents got to pick some sunflowers and bring them home and enjoy those. So that was a fun outing that we really enjoyed. Then we had We celebrated National Hot Dog Day. And again, there's different hot dog days. And we celebrated ours. And we decided to have a hot dog bar. And Barbara did a wonderful job of showing different styles of hot dog. You had Chicago dogs, an all-American dog, chili cheese conies. And then we had this big, long bar of all the fixings that you could possibly imagine. I've never really seen a hot dog bar in person, and it was a sight to behold, I'll tell you that. We were eating good that day for sure. That's the one thing about the Villages is you will not be hungry. That is for sure.
Yeah, that's always awesome.
Always eating, and the food's just getting better and better.
Well, and a hot dog bar is a pretty cool thing. I mean, you can doctor up your hot dog in just about any way you want to eat it, and maybe have one that you've never had before. So that's a cool experience.
Absolutely. And it was a great opportunity for residents to maybe try different things with people putting jalapenos on hot dogs and all kinds of different stuff. It was awesome. And then the staff, of course, we had a hot dog eating contest with the staff. I won't tell you who won that one, but the residents really enjoyed that as well. So today we're actually having, today is National Wine and Cheese Day. So we're going to have a wine and cheese social, and our chef, Barbara, has made charcuterie boards. So we're going to have a little wine and some cheese and a little meats in there as well. And so we're just going to have a nice social hour where we sit and talk about different things and enjoy some wine and cheese. So that's going to be later on this afternoon. Upcoming things we've got last week of July and the first week of August. It's a split week. We've got the Villages Olympics. So, the Olympics are coming up, so we're doing our own. We take all of the activities that we do, just throughout the month, and we're going to make them Olympic style. So it's going to be a competition. We're going to have medals, but we're going to start and end the week with two parties. We'll have a party on Monday and a party on Friday. The Monday party is going to be themed after France, because Paris is hosting the Olympics, so we've already got our berets ready, and we're having a French themed meal for Monday. And then the Friday is going to be a Greek theme, because the Olympics originated in Greece, so we're going to bust out our togas and have some Greek food. We're going to start off August strong.
Jeb Bowers has been our guest here from the Villages of Murfreesboro, talking about a lot of the activities going on there. Find out more at thevillagesmurfreesboro.com, 2550 Willow Oak Trail.
This is Stan Vaught. I'm a lot like you, a husband, father, farmer, auctioneer, and community supporter. I'm now a candidate for school board in the Las Casas, Walter Hill, Milton, Leanna, Oakland, and Siegel communities. I believe in community schools, vocational education, and getting education back to the basics. I'd appreciate your support for school board.
Early voting going on now through July 27th. Election day is August 1st. Paid for by Stan Vaught for school board, Stan Vaught treasurer.
This is Pastor Nikki Ajapong, the lead pastor of Holy Hill Chapel in Murfreesboro.
Hear our sermons on WGNS every Sunday night at 7:30.
Everyday life, never take it for granted.
Visit holyhillchapeltn.org to hear our podcast.
It's a blessing.
Market declines, unemployment, oil prices. Don't let headlines derail your long-term financial strategy. I'm Edward Jones Financial Advisor Lee Colvin. I'll work with you to help you understand the impact of short-term events and how to be positioned for the long term. We provide the tools for a disciplined approach to investing. Call 615-907-7056 for an opportunity to discuss your situation. Edward Jones, Making Sense of Investing, member SIPC.
My wife had Alzheimer's. I knew we were going to have to move closer to my son because we had no family in Florida.
Residents at the Villages of Murfreesboro say it best.
Having the memory care in the same facility was a big factor. This place is all I could ever dream it would be.
I'm Hope Rogers. Call me at the Villages of Murfreesboro. 615-848-3030.
Hi, this is Gator with Tire World Off-Road. We are your local Rough Country dealer. So when you're ready to add some character to your rig, ask for Gator at Tire World Off-Road on Memorial Boulevard.
This is Sean Brown at Tire World on Broad Street. Online at tireworld.us.
The Wake Up Crew, WGNS.
With Brian Barrett, John Dinkins, and Dalton Barrett.
Back here on the Wake Up Crew from News Radio WGNS. It's Brian and John here at 7:30 on a Thursday.
And happy birthday today to Tom Crager. He's starting to show it, isn't he? Shows his age a little bit. Yeah, Clark Blair. Oh, certainly. Kevin Furr, Peyton Hodge, Bill Nash, and Debbie Kalish. Happy birthday from WGNS.
So those are the names that we have so far this morning. We actually came into the morning with those. If you've called or text already this morning, hey, we've got them. We're going to announce them here in about a half an hour. If you haven't, this is your deadline to get in birthdays and anniversaries. The number is 615-893-1450. Slick Pig Barbecue Birthday Club. All right, taking a look at local news, traffic, and weather for you right now.
For more than 30 years, my team and I have worked hard to help injured people throughout Middle Tennessee. If you've been injured, call the law offices of John Day for a free consultation. Learn more at johndaylegal.com.
Checking your Rutherford County weather. Patchy fog possible in spots early today. Otherwise, mostly cloudy. Showers and storms in the area. Highs top out near 86 degrees. Winds north-northwesterly, around 5 miles per hour. Tonight, chance for more showers and storms. Patchy fog could redevelop in spots after midnight. Lows drop to 71. Then shower and storm chances continue on Friday. I'm weatherology meteorologist Phil Jenska with your Wake Up Crew forecast. Right now it's 73.
Good morning. THB remains on the scene of this early morning truck crash here in Rutherford County, 840 eastbound, right up from Jefferson Pike. It's been limping along up through here, mostly rubbernecking delays for the last hour or so. Now it's busy leaving Rutherford County on 24 west as you head towards Nashville through the Antioch area. It's starting to get a little bit more saturated there, 65 southbound, coming off that ramp from Vietnam Vets, headed down through Madison. Hey, whether you need a new roof, roof repair, or roof inspection, independent roofing specialists, these guys have got you covered. Check out irsroofs.com. I'm Commander Chuck with your on-time traffic.
Now, an update from the WGNSradio.com News Center.
I'm Ron Jordan. Police in Murfreesboro are investigating a possible simple assault that took place on Target Tuesday around 2:30 p.m. Police say the woman victim is okay. Officers are currently working to identify the man involved in the incident. Authorities have assured the public that there is no immediate threat. The investigation is ongoing, and police are asking anybody with any information to come forward. More details as we get them on WGNS. Tennessee tourism generated a record $30.6 billion in direct visitor spending and saw 144 million visitors to the state in 2023. Newly released data from Tourism Economics and the Tennessee Department of Tourist Development says Tennessee's direct visitor spending increased 6.2% in 2023. This follows two consecutive years of double-digit growth, driving Tennessee to a 125% recovery over 2019 pre-pandemic levels. Tourism revenue in Rutherford County has risen significantly every year for the past 3 years. When county-by-county numbers for the last year are released, the upward trend is expected to be confirmed once again. We are in the final stretch for early voting. The last day to vote early is this Saturday. The state and federal primary, the Rutherford County general election, and Murfreesboro City municipal races. Ballots could be cast at any polling location in the county, which means you can cast your vote at the most convenient polling station. If you're voting early at the elections office on the public square, you can vote from 7 a.m. to 7 p.m. weekdays, 8 to noon on Saturday. Poll hours at all other locations are weekdays from 10 to 6, and Saturday from 8 to noon. News on demand 24/7 at WGNSradio.com. I'm Ron Jordan reporting.
The Good Neighbor Network, on air and online at WGNSradio.com. Rutherford County's most trusted source for local news.
When you turn to Turner Security, powered by TechCore, you can leave your security issues at the door.
Security, access control, cameras, and much more for your business and home. No long-term contract. We keep your business because we did a great job, not because you signed a five-year agreement. One call does it all for your security and technology needs. Online at turnersecurity.us. That's turnersecurity.us.
Turn to Turner Security.
If your job situation is changing because of layoffs or restructuring, you may have to make several decisions. One important decision may be what to do with your retirement plan. Make sure your retirement stays on track. I'm Lee Colvin, your Edward Jones Financial Advisor, and I'd like to help. Stop by our office in the Public Shopping Center on South Rutherford Boulevard or give us a call at 615-907-7056 for a face-to-face appointment. Edward Jones, Making Sense of Investing, member SIPC.
Hey, we get it.
Life's busy, and the last thing you need to worry about is where your trash goes and how much it's going to cost you. With Middle Point Landfill, Rutherford County residents receive free disposal.
Mike Klassen with Middle Point Landfill.
We pride ourselves in making your waste one less worry. Take it to the curb, and we'll take it from there.
Middle Point Landfill is an environmentally safe, economical, and reliable solution for solid waste for Rutherford County.
Learn more about us at middlepointlandfill.com.
The Wake Up Crew, WGNS.
With Brian Barrett, John Dinkins, and Dalton Barrett.
Our time is 7:35, and it is the Wake Up Crew here from News Radio WGNS on a Throwback Thursday.
Do you remember these?
Well, we're going to put ourselves to the test. Do you remember these Rutherford County restaurants that have come and gone? Trappers. Do you remember Trappers?
I do. They're good place to eat.
Southeast Broad, where Party Fowl is located.
Well, there have been a lot of places in that. There have been a lot of things in that. Started out as a steakhouse, I think.
I think it was a Western Sizzlin'.
Maybe, yeah.
And I'm pretty sure that's where Jim Demas, that's what got the Demases to Murfreesboro, and then he wound up opening Demases. Trappers was kind of like, I guess, maybe like an O'Charlie's or Ruby Tuesday's kind of thing. Do you remember the Santa Fe Cantina?
Yes, I love the Santa Fe Cantina.
That is another restaurant that occupied that same space where that, Party Fowl
is. And then they went over to where Staples is. That way. I remember going there after church. That was almost like every Sunday, Santa Fe. You could get in. Service was good. Food was good.
Now, here's one that opened and was opened in 2014 and only was here for about 5 years, but the Green Dragon. It was a little pub. I had restaurant type food there.
I don't remember that. I don't remember the Green Dragon.
Yeah. Let's see. Kebab Cuisine in the mid 90s. It's where the alley on Main is. Kind of had a Middle Eastern type of flair to it. Here's one that we've talked about several times here on the show. I remember it from the 80s as a kid and think it was here through early 90s. That's Chesney's.
Oh, great place. That one will go down in history. That was really, really good.
Right there at the corner of Memorial and Northfield, where the Murphy Express gas station is now.
Yeah.
That's where they had the restaurant.
They had that little strip mall behind it, kind of.
Yeah. Now it's still there. I think Red Food was originally opened in
that. Yeah, what's there now? Probably a workout place, isn't it?
I believe so. Yeah.
All old grocery store places
kind of turned into that. Yeah. So, Chesney's, now let's talk a little bit about the Cooker. You remember the Cooker?
Uh-huh.
It was here from, I guess, maybe early to mid-90s to about 2004 when they closed. They were on Northwest Broad Street.
They didn't stay open as long as I thought, and their food was good. Kind of a mix of a meat and three and a fancy restaurant, you know?
Yeah, you could get
mashed potatoes, cornbread, that kind of stuff.
Right.
But
you also had your steaks.
Yeah.
That you could get there. Once it closed, what opened up in that place was Paleo's.
Okay.
And then, of course, Paleo's left, and that's now where
Paleo's
Hooters
is. Here a good while, though, weren't they?
It was, yeah, from, I guess, 2004 or 5 until just a few years ago, honestly. To Smyrna, the Omni Hut.
Oh.
That was always a very special place to go. The poo-poo platter.
Couldn't beat it.
No.
It was so dark in there, remember?
It was dark.
You couldn't hardly see what you were eating. It was so dark.
Closed in 2018. And
that long ago?
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah, sure did. And here's one that I don't know if you remember. It was in the spot where Camino is called Raz's.
Yeah, I never went there, but I remember it.
They kind of had Cajun dishes and things like that there. A lot of people talked about that. The Red Rose Coffee Shop, of course, that was open, where Red Rose used to be the dairy, I guess. And let's see.
Duff's Smorgasbord.
Duff's?
Mm-hmm.
Forgot about Duff's. It's been a long time. I don't think it was here when I was born, rather. I think it was before May me. I remember going to one in Pigeon Forge in that area, but I think it's gone now. What about Rio Bravo Cantina?
Yeah, that was good. What happened? Why do these good restaurants go out? I don't understand.
So Rio Bravo is where Chewy's is now on Broad Street. Yeah. So you had Rio Bravo and Chili's is still there, and you had Cooker across the street. It's when you had a lot of those restaurants there. And that is a look back at some of the restaurants that have come and gone here in Rutherford County on Throwback Thursday.
Who buys Habitat for Humanity homes?
People who are working, and they work hard. Generally, it's 40 to 80% of the area median income.
And everyone can support the dream of home ownership by shopping at the Habitat Restore.
We have 20 future homeowners in our program right now.
It just does so much for the community.
Please shop at the Habitat Restore, 850 Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. Boulevard.
French's, the name to trust. French's, depend on us. French's, a great selection too. We take pride in pleasing you. Get brand names at a lower price. The French family really treats you nice. It makes good sense to shop at French's. French's Shoes and Boots.
That's French's Shoes and Boots, 1837 South Church Street in Murfreesboro.
At Heritage South Community Credit Union, we help when others won't. It's what our members tell us we do every day. The older model car you need to get to work? Yeah, we've helped with that. When you have a financial emergency and don't know where to turn, we've helped with that. Repairing your credit? Yes, we've helped with that. How about a second chance at a checking account? We've even helped with that. Experience the Heritage South difference. Learn more at heritagesouth.org. Insured by NCUA, Equal Housing Lender.
This is Stan Vaught. I'm a lot like you, a husband, father, farmer, auctioneer, and community supporter. I'm now a candidate for school board in the Las Casas, Walter Hill, Milton, Leanna, Oakland, and Sigel communities. I believe in community schools, vocational education, and getting education back to the basics. I'd appreciate your support for school board.
Early voting going on now through July 27th. Election day is August 1st. Paid for by Stan Vaught for school board, Stan Vaught treasurer.
The Wake Up Crew, WGNS.
With Brian Barrett, John Dinkins, and Dalton Barrett.
Wrapping up the Wake Up Crew here for this Thursday morning, July 25th, episode 1456, just about in the books. Here this morning, saying good morning to Wes McCurry, our good neighbor of the day today, for helping with a car issue and coming through with a rental when needed. Wes McCurry, a good neighbor indeed. And Wes is going to receive flowers today from Ryan Flowers Coffee and Gifts and News Radio WGNS as the good neighbor of the day. If you would like to send in a good neighbor, we've got multiple ways to get them to us. Text neighbor to 615-893-1450. And when you get that link from us, tap on it, fill out the info. You can get to that same web form at WGNSradio.com/goodneighbor. Also, you can call this afternoon, talk to Melissa. You can also throw it in the mail to us, 306 South Church Street, Murfreesboro, 37130. Today's Wake Up Crew is powered by Middle Tennessee Electric, who offers some energy-saving tips during the hot summer months, installing a programmable thermostat that will automatically adjust temperatures for optimal comfort and energy savings is one of those tips, and you can find more at mte.com/myenergyplan.
Time for the dad joke of the day.
Replay.
Well, today's dad joke goes a little something like this. You know, I was driving down the road, and there was a lobster stand, and it said lobster tails for $2. So I gave him $2, and he said, "Once upon a time, there was a lobster."
Replay.
I gave that a 4.
You did. Said it had a surprise ending.
More like a, okay, 4. We'll just stay with 4. Yeah. I don't want to get the look.
What have we learned on the Wake Up Crew today?
Yes, we talked about restaurants that used to be here. We left a few out.
Yeah.
But there, that was a good little list.
What was the one on Northfield that we talk about all the time?
Meacham's,
yeah.
Quincy's, it's another one.
Yeah.
So there's several.
We had a Golden Corral at one time.
I hate you for even bringing that up. You know how I love Golden Corral.
Uh-huh.
I wonder if it's still in Cooville.
Probably.
Oh, we'll never go there again. Yeah. I've noticed on our road trips,
wants to go to Cooville.
I've noticed on our road trips, we don't go anywhere anymore.
Yeah, we went to Chattanooga twice last year.
No, we don't go anywhere to eat on our road trip. Let me clarify that. Mm. Oh, let's just get a pretzel here at the stadium.
They had pretzels.
Boy, so good. We can get something. They'll have something up there to eat. And we get up there, the food's gone. Reason number 732. Now I'm going to use a highlighter on the football schedule.
What else have you learned today, Mr. Grumpy
Pants? I haven't really learned anything much other than that. What did you talk about? You talk about rat brains.
There was a rat brain study.
Yeah, rat brain study.
If we're doing something fun, time goes by faster than it does if you're just kind of
bored. So what were the rats doing again that was making it so much fun?
They gave them things to do that made them happy.
Oh, okay.
And they could see the brain activity.
Which tells you how much I listened to it the first time.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
Yep.
When you start rattling off, I just kind of go into a daze.
Well, is that it?
I'll be happier tomorrow.
We'll see about that.
Be Friday.
Well, it will be a Friday.
Yeah, looking forward to it.
Well, we will see you then. If you missed any part of the Wake Up Crew this morning, you can listen back to the podcast at WGNSradio.com. Just look for the podcast section and Wake Up Crew. It'll be up here in about a half an hour.
Next on the Wake Up Crew, the stupid, silly stat of the day.
You know, Sylvester Stallone still has the turtles from the Rocky movie, and they're 40 years old.
Wow. I didn't know there were any turtles in the Rocky movie.
I didn't either.
That's pretty cool.
There were turtles in the 75 Rocky movie.
Wow.
And they're still here. How about that? Song of the day this morning, the second biggest hit of 1985.